Rohit, good evening and nice to see you on TIN.
Thank you.
So you have come down all the way from Goa. You are in Bangalore, then Goa and...
Yeah, the life has been crazy in last few weeks because working on social media a week, it's a very large scale event. So 5 days, more than 80 plus sessions happening, more than 120 speakers. Plus you have the regular work, your clientele and other projects which are going on. So I was not supposed to be in Goa, but I landed up in Goa and then I flew today to
Bombay. Fantastic. So just give me a short journey about your life as an entrepreneur and how did up to R Square. Small, short journey.
Journey, 97, I landed up in Bangalore without having a clue what to do in life. And I had no clarity what sales is or what marketing is. So I started working for a dealer. Worked there for 4 months and I said, no, this is not what I'm supposed to do it.
Computer dealer?
No, I was selling gensets. Okay. I sold gensets shop to shop, home to home.
Okay.
And then I cut off and then actually I worked for Just Dial, which has become today very huge. At that point of time, Just Dial was really struggling. And once again, same thing, going shop to shop and getting registrations and very tough because when you go and talk to people about talking Yellow Pages, nobody understands what you're talking Yellow Pages at that point of time. So that I did, and I joined Cyber Media because I wanted to get into media. I think by the time I figured out that I actually want to get into marketing, and one of my clients gave me the opportunity to come into marketing, and that was Cobian. It's a Singapore-based organization. That's how I got
Bothra,
into marketing.
Bothra.
You're right, Rajesh Bothra. So I handled the channel marketing and communication, PR for that organization for 4.5 years, and established a brand in the channel at that point of time. And then AMD happened. Always loved to work for an organization which was, say, underdogs and always competing with Intel, and it was very difficult to do it. I can say 2004 to 2008 for AMD in India was a golden period.
Absolutely.
We did amazing work and we actually could challenge Intel in India, I can say that. And especially when we got a support from the OEMs like HP, Acer, Lenovo, all these guys. Then I joined SanDisk. I was looking after marketing for India. That's when I started feeling that I think the time has come when I have to do something on my own. Quit SanDisk, took a sabbatical, found my passion of photography because I was spending a lot of time in the jungles. And I said, no. So I got very clear that I want to do a wildlife and nature photography. And R Square, I wanted to build up using all the experience which I have got over the period of time. So that's when R Square happened. So July 2010, we launched R Square. So being a marketing services firm, when we started adding on other different services. And last year, we got into the brand properties. So 2013 was a year when we did Social Media Week debut edition in India. Then we established one more property called Nature in Focus. It's a wildlife photography festival, which we did last March. First time a festival like that happened. We had more than 300 participants. We got Steve Winter, he's a National Geographic contributor, to come all the way from US. And we had naturalists, conservationists, nature lovers. So that festival actually was for the nature lovers. And yeah, now I sit here.
So you love wildlife photography.
I mean,
your full timeline is only, I was showing my son that day, especially that lizard, the way you captured it, going and eating that frog over there. It's really fantastic. So you actually go out in the field and
Yes. To do a wildlife photography, you need to get into field and you need to have a lot of patience and you need to understand the ecology.
Okay.
So these are the three basics. And apart from that, you need to have an eye to shoot. So composition also comes in the way. And that's pretty important. So first thing is patience. Wildlife photography is really difficult. You need to have a lot of patience. It teaches you a lot of things. And ecology is so important today. Everybody's talking about conservation, but how much of effort actually are we doing to conserve the conservation? And I feel photographers actually have huge responsibility because what they capture, they actually showcase to the world by which they can make people more sensitive about the nature. So you have to spend a lot of time in the field. And I do a bit what I can do for the conservation also.
And you have to be very strong as a photographer also, to carry all those big bazooka like lenses over there.
Yes, you end up carrying big lenses, fortunately, unfortunately.
So what's your favorite camera you use?
I use a 5D Mark II.
Okay.
And I use now 200-400
lens. Okay.
Yeah. I used to use a 300 prime earlier.
Mm-hmm.
So now I have moved to 200-400.
Okay, fantastic. So you managed to pull off one of the largest social media events in the world. How did it happen? How did you get Social Media Week into India?
2012, we started talking to them, and they wanted us to give them a reasons that why it should be given to us. So we did a complete presentation talking about India, talk about what is happening in India, talk about the abilities what we have as R-Square. R-Square has pretty unique abilities because we are a digital and social media agency, and apart from that, we actually do a lot of events and activation also. So amalgamation of it, you will see it happening in Social Media Week. So we did pitch, a proper pitch which we did, and they got confused, or they got convinced. So they gave us a project and we started working on it. And they land up in India and they were shocked when the event happened. So they never actually thought event is going to be so big in India, and the first edition itself is going to be so huge. We did outdoor, we did radio, we did huge amount of social buzz. We were trending for all the 5 days. And we actually had good speakers. So experts came actually on board. Social media is if I say, it is all about collaboration. It's not the event which is done by R-Square, but all the partners, like Sam himself, he actually came and he said he will handle the social part of it, he will do the photography. So it's all about the partnerships, completely collaboration. Today also, if you look at Social Media Week, this edition, you look at the kind of partners what we have. And they are coming because they find it to be a right platform. Simple.
So it's more of the partners coming out, helping. It's a total collaborative effort.
It is a complete collaborative effort.
And every day I read one new partner signing up, and one new partner. Every day one more new partner is coming over. So it's going to stop on Sunday.
It has actually been stopped now.
Okay.
So we had so many requests coming for the partnerships or for the sponsorships, or people wanted to come and speak at the event, or they want to be an event host, or they want to volunteer. So many requests actually come. So we try to accommodate whatever we can. End of the day, we have got 5 days, and we can run 4 or 5 different sessions at the same time. So you have 5 parallel tracks running at the same time at the 3 days. On day one and the last day, we have one single track going on. And that's like those 2 days are a high power days. So we're expecting almost like 300, 350 people on those days.
It's much better. It's at one location now, because last year I went crazy, going to Barking Deer and there, like it was, but it was fun. It was a lot of fun.
Yeah, so we normally take the feedback from our partners, from the audience to improvise. And even in Bangalore also, we try to do everything in UB City. We did manage to get 3 venues in that area, and then other 2 venues were outside. So this time we decided that we will have one venue. And the way we work actually is that we look at what kind of content is going to appeal to the audience. So it's just not about doing an event, it's all about the content. If the content is relevant, you will have people coming up there, and the right speakers. So we know advertising and marketing is one audience which would love to come. Then we wanted to have a social and community. So that's the reason we have a complete track running on social and community. Then we have another track running on masterclasses. We call it as a learning stage. So masterclasses, workshop, dedicated track running for this. And then we have one more which is for startups and entrepreneurs like us. So they want to know what can be done, how can be done. So we have very good sessions being lined up for the startups and entrepreneurs also.
Fantastic. Tell us something about how did you manage to get these great speakers like Sean Gardner, Jeff Bullas and all? How did it come? Because they are such big celebrities themselves. What convinced them to come to India?
What convinced them? See, social media is very important. If you look at India as a market, looking at the our population and the current internet base and the social media base itself, it's growing at a very, very high speed. We are talking about 200 plus million users right now. More than 100 million users are there on the Facebook itself. We just wrote a mail. Actually, my colleague Bindu just wrote a mail to Sean, to Jeff, and we requested them to come out to Social Media Week Bangalore. So they said, what is happening? We just told them this is what is happening, but if you ask about the schedule, we don't have it, because it takes time to build up a schedule. Being a crowdsource event, it takes time to build up a schedule. Very frankly, today morning also changes are happening in the schedule. This is how dynamic Social Media Week is. And they were very happy to come to India.
I know Sean is very excited.
He's really excited to come to India. He's never been to India. He wants to go to Agra to see the Taj Mahal. So I said, fine. So we arranged for him to go to Agra so that he can see the Taj Mahal also.
He's coming on tomorrow, no?
Yes, I think tomorrow night he's landing here.
Fantastic. Tell us something about your family. And how do you
have a son.
Okay.
So I'm trying to take him to the nature and make him a nature lover.
Okay.
So that
how old is he?
He's 10 years old.
Okay.
So I'm just trying to put in effort to see that he becomes more conscious about the nature. So yeah, he has started enjoying being in the nature, started understanding how the ecology functions. Now when he looks at the images, he actually asked me that how I'm shooting it. So I got him a camera very recently. He started picking up. And obviously I'm not pushing him to do it. It's just that he likes it.
It's in his genes.
Watches.
It's in his genes over there.
So I took like, so I belong to a very small place in Madhya Pradesh called Balaghat. And at that point of time, I was very close to nature because I had best possible national parks around Balaghat. So Kanha National Park is there, Pench is there, Nagjira, Navegaon, all these places are there. So my summer vacations used to be in that place. When I moved to Bangalore and then got into corporate world, everything got changed. Then you are running, always running. So one company to another company, you are traveling, especially in AMD and SanDisk, I used to travel extensively. So I got disconnected with this. One visit to Bandipur, I remember the year and the month very clearly, which is July 2010. Everything got changed. I just went there, had no booking, walked into one resort, stayed over there, went for a safari, and I had a one first proper tiger sighting in July 2010. And believe me, every month after that, I used to be in the forest, either in Bandipur, Kabini, or PR Hills. 1 year, no sighting. That's what nature is. 1 year I spent every month religiously, 2-3 nights I used to stay there, and nothing. So then what happens is, then the whole philosophy will change. The wildlife photography is not about tigers or leopards. Then you start looking at the rest of the animals, and then you start finding the beauty of the nature. So yeah, I think I actually love nature. So I plan to retire very soon and then settle down in one of the jungles.
So you prefer a portrait mode of photography or a landscape mode of photography?
I love to shoot habitat.
Okay.
So if you look at my photographs, you will not find much of portraits.
Okay.
So I love to show the subject with the habitat. So that's what I like to shoot.
Okay. And any time have you got featured on any magazine or something like that?
Yes, Smart Photography did an article which is almost like 7 pages, and they took a lot of pictures from me. African Geographic, they did a complete blog on me. Then recently Hindu wrote about how I quit the corporate world and got into the photography.
Fantastic.
So some of the articles have come, and there's another magazine, Savis, so they published some of the photographs.
Whom do you admire?
A lot of people, actually. So one guy I really love, when I look at the passion, very frankly, is Steve Jobs. His passion, and he's a maverick, or he was a maverick. Another factor is, I think he was a great marketeer. And the way he has introduced all his products has been amazing. The way he has pitched, the way he has understood the consumers, or what consumer is looking for. His language was never technical. He actually spoke the way we speak, and that's what made him different.
Correct.
So I actually admire him.
Okay. So one person you admire the most.
I've been highly inspired. So when I look at my presentations, I always look at how he would have done it.
Okay. Okay, so we have now Quick Gun Sam, which is one word witty answer.
Okay.
Okay. So I'll tell you something and you're going to give me one word for that.
Okay.
Camera.
I'll try.
Camera.
I.
Money.
Doesn't matter.
Family.
Works.
SMW.
Lifeline right now.
Entrepreneurship.
Journey.
Politics.
Hate.
Narendra Modi.
Admire him.
So that's one up for him. Okay. Ian is going to have a word with you afterwards. Okay, what are you looking forward to next?
What I look forward to the next is, I want to see that how this whole effort which we are putting right now, either in Social Media Week or Nature in Focus, how it can help the larger audience. Mm. So it's just not about doing an event. One, we don't call Social Media Week as an event. Mm. We call it as a festival.
Okay.
So it has to benefit the larger audience, larger group of people. So that is what we are actually working on. How it can benefit. So it's just not about come there, meet up with some few people, network with them, listen to some talks. We need to go beyond that. So if we can help, for example, startups and entrepreneurs, and that's the reason we have actually focused on startups and entrepreneurs in a real way. Thai has come on board, and they are also doing a lot of events with us. And that's a vision what we have. So do something for the community.
Fantastic. And a story which inspired you and changed your life as an entrepreneur. What is that thing which made you, I got to quit this 9-to-5 job and become an entrepreneur? What is that one spark, one inspiring thing which happened to you?
Okay, so why I quit the job? One, I wanted freedom. Okay, I was actually kind of getting really suffocated with the corporate life. So that it was never a 9-to-6 job. It was more of a 9-to-9 or 9-to-12 kind of a job. So that was one factor. And second thing is, very frankly, I wanted to focus on my photography.
Okay.
And for that, you need time. Hmm. So when you are off your mobile phones and machine, that's what I wanted to do it. Hmm. That's what actually entrepreneurship or being in R Square could happen. I could actually spend a lot of time in the jungles. So rather than a story, it was more of my thought process, why I quit the corporate world and start doing what I want to do it. Extension of my photography is Nature in Focus. Hmm. So that's the role, or say the route which I have taken right now.
Okay.
That how we are able to make more and more people aware what we have done with the nature and how important it is to conserve the nature.
Hmm. Fantastic. Great having you here.
Thank you.
Indian Networker and Jam with Sam. I look forward to interacting with you from Monday on. No, I think Sunday, na? You are going for the chai pakoda, right?
You're right. So we have a marquee event happening. That's the bike ride with IBW. We did last year also. That time we did not focus. We did on last day.
So I remember it's
11th hour calling you and saying that, okay, we need some support for that. But this time we have done it in a much more organized way. And Khushbu is here. She is doing an unconference for the bikers.
Okay.
So she is going to speak to the bikers to figure out that how the communities are building because of social media. And biking is a very close-knit community. They are pretty active on social. And they actually plan their trips, even trips which are beyond say Bombay or any of the cities. So social media plays a huge role. So that's the idea, that we actually go there, do one conference, get some insights for them, which can be used for the larger communities.
So it's going to start at, where is it starting from?
I think it's a Fountain Hotel.
Fountain Hotel at Godbandha Road.
Yeah.
And then it's going to Charoti.
Yes.
So it's a 1 or 2 hour drive?
It's like 1 hour, hour and a half hours drive. Yes.
So
that's what has been planned.
I have to also come over there.
Yes.
I've been told that.
We'll be
but I'm going to come in the Jeep. I'm going to come on the bike over there.
Come with the Jeep. We have the Jeep. That also open Jeep.
Open Jeep. My friend, the guy who was there last night, a photographer, he said, okay, sir, I don't like to get up in the morning. I'm just going to go and take photo. I'm coming back. And his brothers called me, where is he? He went on the bike to join. He took out some 300 photographs. Yeah. I said, who's going to edit all those photographs, upload those photographs over there? Like, it was, I mean, everybody enjoyed that so much over there.
So right now, if I remember 2 days ago when we looked at the Facebook event page for the bike ride, we had more than 400 bikers actually signed up.
Okay.
So we are expecting minimum 200 people to turn up. Last time itself, we have almost like 80-odd
bikers.
So this time is going to be 200-plus bikers actually coming. So that's huge.
So you have all mix of bikes?
Yes, it is all mix of bikes.
So
we are not looking at only one brand as such.
Okay.
Anybody who's passionate about biking, he's most welcome to come.
Rohit, fantastic having you here. And look forward to working with you next week more, both me and Sandeep. Fantastic.
Thank you.